Hey, what is going on? How is everybody today? We're getting back into Endzone, A World Apart. It is a management sim game. Post-apocalyptic, a lot of radiation involved. And of course, dealing with all your little peoples. They are coming out with a new DLC soon. Distant Places. So that is going to make the world larger. I believe there's some more traveling. Different kinds of seeds, some new buildings. So, in preparation for that DLC dropping, I'm going to get back into this and get a little play in to get accustomed to the game again. So, hey, if you haven't, do me a huge solid. Hit that like button, subscribe. They're both free, helps the channel out, and I would greatly appreciate it. Why not? It's free! Alright, here we go. Survival. We're gonna put it on the normal mode. Medium mountain, low mountain. Keep those things out of the way. Low mountains. And... Bremerton. Let's go. So I've got a couple hours in it over the weekend so far. Just to get accustomed to it, so we're gonna get rolling
this
here.
This looks like a good place to settle. You know what we learned in the Endzone. Basic needs come first and foremost. We have to build up a water and food supply, and then...
You should not talk with your mask on because it sounds like this, lady. Oh my gosh. Take the mask off! Alright. First thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna check for radiation. Oh, we got radiation right here. So what I'm gonna do is, right off the bat... They can knock out this real quickly. I'm gonna put them to work right on that, and then they can cut wood right there. Water, always the biggest issue, right? Left that there. And I'll put this right there. So we put a jetty. The jetty allows them to go out there and collect water. This, the castern, which holds the water, right? Got that going. They're removing that. We got this guy over here doing this. We're going to get somebody doing, gathering some plants up for us. Preferably not the area of the trees we're cutting down, so we're gonna do that there. And, workforce, we need to make sure we have a couple builders. There we go. Build a little road here, by the way. There we go. And let's go. Get to work. Speed up time a little bit. I don't know if I'm really super happy with the lake being this close. run through this. Hopefully they clear a lot of this out. It's raining, right? Yeah, it's raining. We gotta see what it looks like when it's not raining. But we got another lake right here, too, which really doesn't matter inside the droughts. Biggest thing is getting water collected. Move this guy. There. Let's go ahead and throw up these. You're gonna do resources. And a scrapyard. So these yards, scrapyard, the forest lodge, the scrapyard, if we go into food, the hunters, the fishing, those allow you to actually I get one on plastic and one on pushing all the buttons wrong. All right, now we can send this guy and he can collect all, where's the closest junk that's going to be in our way? Probably over here this way. This junk will probably have to get out of the way first before we get to worry about this junk. So you can move that spot. Say it's kind of like the same thing as having one of these, but it's a little faster. What's going to happen if I put out just a scrap collector? It's going to gather it into piles. Instead of bringing it in here to be processed. So, and they do it a little faster, and you can assign more people here. If you use these little outpost ones there, as you pull people into different jobs, they get pulled out of these. They're good to have. If you have people sitting around, they will fill those jobs. Alright, here's what I like to do. I like to keep this screen open so I can see how many people are doing what and where. One thing I wish they did with this game is, as people die, get old, or die off because of something, and they leave these jobs vacant, and you get more people that either become adults or, you know, their jobs are done, it would autofill into these spots. Alright, they finally finished removing all of that. We got 1,500 water. This thing holds 2,000. But this one will hold water, correct? But it will not survive a drought. It only has as much water as they collect. A well, actually, will survive a drought. That's the thing I got right there. One more thing for food. We got food right now, but we got a drought coming up. What I'm gonna do is, now we're getting scrap. They're collecting plastic and they're making cloth up here at the top. We have some medicines. We have some radiation protection. What else I want to get going right away? One more food resource, which is kind of good, especially when you have water, is we're going to put a fishing hut right here. This guy's still cutting trees down. These guys are building, which you can do. If you want to speed up building, you can actually like that. That'll speed up your building, add more workers. You need one person to sit on the well. So the well will hold 350, but it's always going to produce water. That's the important thing. Let me connect my little road. I don't know how important roads are in this, pathways are in this game. Alright, he's done over here with collecting wood, right? Boom, bang, we move this guy over here. He can collect all these trees right here. Get those out of the way. Alright, we got food, we got cloth, we got water. We got a drought coming in a few days. We got 15 homeless people, so we are going to have to put people in houses. If they have houses, they will reproduce. So, and they'll reproduce quickly. Housing. I think what I'm going to do is, I'm going to go with, now I try to put my housing a little further away from all my production, for the simple fact that it's, if you look here, here, these yellow ones are negative influences. So I would like to put my housing a bit further away. So we're going to put, I'm going to put four houses. I'm going to leave a gap. I'll leave a gap right there. And put shelter. So, each house. Two adults, three children. That's the max. Two adults, three children, right? We have 15 adults. That's what we got right now. So, here comes the drought. So, four houses, that's 12 people. The rest will go in here. They can't reproduce when they're in the shelter. But it holds 25 people. You can actually... Let me get rid of the screen. You can actually determine the age group that you want to hold in there. So, it actually helped a little bit. I really didn't pay attention with this one road. Straight up like this. We're getting low on food too. All right. So in your shelter, it has all settlers are old and infertile, so you can kind of change that. As the playthrough goes, we can move the older people into here, and we can kind of play with that to like fluctuate our reproduction cycles. Let me move this guy. Get rid of those trees there. We are super low on food. Because I never started that crap. Catch me some fish before the drought hits. How many people we still got left? I still got a bunch of builders. Food's gonna be the thing. Let's go ahead and do this if we can. Go ahead and throw a hunter's cabin down. Right there. Many of the settlers are getting older, Chief, and they think that it's time to have some kids. Now, this is why I only built 4 houses, because they want me to build a house. They'll randomly come up and ask for a house to be built. I wouldn't go over 10 houses. I think the highest that in my playthroughs I've gotten to like 8 or 9 so far. Let's put some hunters together. Alright, hunters, same thing. We can move them about. We're gonna send them over. Animals over there. We're gonna have hunt and capture. So they're gonna capture some animals, they're gonna hunt some animals. You'll see what capturing does. Here, let me knock down some builders. We lost our worker on that guy. So we got our food back up 162, so we're doing good. The drought is here. See, there's the water. That's just food keeps bouncing down. So, once they start hunting and bringing in some food, it will be a little better. Let's see. So this is what our housing looks like. -12 here. So we can put. We're gonna put some decorations in there to pump that up. What I will do here is, let's see. All right, you can see already now they already produced 4 kids. Already. Don't forget we have this little, they want a house built. All they'll do is improve some happiness, add some confidence up here. But I want to kick that out for now. Which is fine. We're going to kick that out for now. I'm not ready to expand too much more yet. I want to get a really good hold on food and water situations here. Food is like, ugh. One more person in there. All right, we're getting plastic built up and some cloth built up. We're going to, and we got lumber going. Speaking of lumber, yeah, we got some unhappy people. They're just gonna be that way. So as you can see, we got people probably, let's see, 15 and 8. Why did someone die? get pulled off the job. Since we're not building anything right now. Oh, they're crying about clothing now. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna that will actually give us 5 gas masks, which we kind of do need this. I was hoping to go a little further. You're gonna add. Charcoal plant. Right there. A tailor shop. Right next to it. And then a workshop. Right here. That whole food thing. I'm not gonna close off this road yet. Where are we laying at as far as people? Oh, we have plenty of people here. Charcoal. This one, right now, I'm gonna have them make just cloth masks. Workshop, they're gonna make scrap metal tools. Oh, are we missing? Oh, we're missing the iron. Ouch. Here. They gotta make us some iron. Yeah. They want four. They want mass over in paint. Kick it over there. That'll give them some protection. Now we're gonna do the carbon to do this. We'll get my free mass. I want to get some charcoal built up there. And then over here, we are just about at the limit, so we are gonna actually upgrade this. Tailor shop done. Cool. Thank you. We'll switch it back over there. They'll finish out that one. Then we're going to switch it over here to these again. Kind of save our charcoal. We've already knocked out a bunch of that cloth. So, alright. They got the metal there so they can start making scrap tools. They want us to collect 2,300 water. They want hard liquor. We're not even ready for that yet. What do we get out of that? Some food and some water? No. This guy's done with lumber. Send him over here. some unhappy people. We got people without tools, blah, blah. Alright, we are going to actually put in next on the boot situation. Now, let's throw a little bit of decoration in. Probably your best bang for your buck. Is the flowers, I would say. You can see what's gonna happen now. This guy's taking the brunt of all this negative stuff. Alright, now we're into green there. There we go. Much better. At least we can add some more stuff in here as we get more resources, but that's better than what we were looking at. Make sure we're not getting any radiation pushing back in. There we go. Now remember, we got this charcoal guy. Here, and that's where our hunters are going also, correct? Hunters are going over here, so we kind of want to leave the woods here for those guys. Our scrapyard. Oh, that's our chopper guy. Scrapyard. He's got a couple more pieces to do before he's done. Remember, we're burning charcoal like mad, so that means we're using up some of our lumber, so we gotta have to watch that a little bit. This one, we activate this thing there. That uses charcoal to purify the water. So by us upgrading that cistern, we went from holding 2,000 to 5,000. That's going on there. Got that going. We got this guy making scrap iron tools, right? So we got this guy over here making bandanas, basically. It's a little bit of protection. So that'll help a little bit. We're gonna have to start getting into the herbs, the medicines, and stuff like that. What are we looking at as far as people? So we got 25 people. So we are, where's there, 17 to 25 living in the big shelter. or 17 of 30 people live in the big shelter. So, we got a bunch of people out here. So, Very old. Some adults, some young adults. So, it's a mix. It's a lot of very old and some adults. So, we're good. That's keeping our population in check a little bit from building houses. What we're gonna have to do is add. So over here we have our recyclers here. Right there. We're out of people. Up on the charcoal. Knock that up one. And we're gonna make, we got cloth, iron. Let's double up on the cloth. Let's make this one plastic. We got four people working there. We got how many people here? One working here. So we're gonna add. One more person in the recycler so they collect a little more. There's nobody to work this. What is this one? This one we can get rid of. This one we're about to get rid of pretty soon. We'll get the forester coming in. What is that? That should be the recycler's done. Yeah. Alright, so we're gonna push him over here, start cleaning all this out. This thing's gonna get uglier and uglier the more things we send over here, right? Okay, is this? Here's what I'm talking about, man. I lost somebody in the refinery right here, but it doesn't automatically replace them in there. I've got two settlers sitting here doing nothing. It doesn't suck them in there. I have to manually go in here and up it again so they get back in there. Alright, charcoal? We're doing okay on charcoal. We're gonna start making some masks. We're gonna up his limit to 200. Oh, I'm out of lumber? Crap. We are gonna have to move this out of here. Let's take out this part. We're just losing people from old age and everything. Now it's kind of balancing people around the around jobs and everything since they're dying of old age. Without overburdening our food and water supply, that's an important thing. If we go into resources and we get a lumber mill up and running. I want to put this guy. Waiting on the lumber guys. Got another drought coming. We should be okay for that one. We lost our fort. Now I'm really gonna have to bounce people around. And then we're gonna have them cut down and reforest, right? Cut down and reforest. Let's do it right there. Let's go ahead and, where is it, right there? Let's pause this guy. Hold off on charcoal, we have like absolutely no lumber. Seven kids, we really need a, you know what would be nice? School. Oh, with the hard liquor, man. Ugh. Let's put a school back over here. We lost our hunters? Ugh. Not a good thing. Cut down on our force. fishing pier's dried up right now, so no fishing, no getting gathering of water. We have let's drop one force guy, put him as a teacher. Productivity, so everybody works faster. And a sandstorm. Ah, that's neat. Great. Sandstorms bring in more radiation. Not too bad. Didn't bring any in. But they do damage. Not too bad. Alright. Kids are going to school, they're learning, they'll be more productive when they're grown-ups or faster. So that's a good thing. So that brings us to season 25. I think we are going to go ahead and save it for today. Thank you so much for coming in and hanging out. Like I said, if you haven't, hit the like, subscribe to the channel. It helps tremendously. I do stream every day, Monday through Friday, 4 a.m. Central U.S. Time, UTC-5, over on Twitch. It's twitch.tv/airframer. There is kind of a link down there. You'd have to copy and paste it. I can't give you a clickable link yet, but come and hang out with us on our live streams over there on Twitch. And if you can't do that, look for more stuff over here on YouTube. Hopefully I see you again in the next video or the next live stream.